Well, during the break, Columbus Blue Jackets welcoming back Pierre-Luc Dubois and Riley Nash, their former players, and a decidedly different reaction.
There, lead pass now. Here's Lekkonen coming in. Lekkonen's got a goal. And there's a shot as he breaks his stick. Rolls gently to Riddick. And look at the smile on his face, like, come on.
Well, I heard Kelly Rudy saying that, right? They're having some fun.
And as he goes to snap this thing, it just, the stick disintegrates.
The Strome. Right down low, he scores! Oh, a great deflection by Chris Kreider!
I don't know if those two are going to be getting along by the time the night's over.
That's the rivalry. Oh, nice pass. Zibanejad to Kreider. He scores! Oh, baby, what a play! There's our couple.
Oh, man, he needs to just go home now.
Yeah. He's not happy.
It's not working out.
The Rangers with a 4-1 win in their first visit to the Islanders' new home in Elmont, New York.
Lilligren shot, scramble in front, they score on the rebound. It's Matthews, it's 3-1.
Well, what a shift from this top line. And you're seeing the puck control from Mitch Marner and Austin Matthews.
And a snafu in the Holland Tunnel delays the Minnesota Wild bus from Manhattan to the Rock. So they had to delay the start of the game from 7 o'clock to 7:33.
You can never trust this traffic around here in general, but especially on this day, Thanksgiving Eve, the busiest travel day of the year.
In the end, it is a 24-minute delay at the start.
You see Kemper coming across, and there the blade is sitting behind him. He doesn't know it's missing yet. And all of a sudden, he's like stepping on a banana peel, and you see his head turn, and he starts yelling at the referee. Jonas Johansson's going to come in here for as short a period of time as they can hope for, as Darcy Kemper gets his skate change. And here comes Darcy Kemper back onto the ice, and the referees will allow him to get back into his net.
He says, I want my net back.
What just happened? He'll have a one-goal lead to work with now, thanks to his partner.
Top of the zone. Long wrist shot tipped by Milano and off the side of the goal. Raquel gets it back on the half wall and feeds it to Drysdale. Middle of the ice, his shot. Oh, Kemper is down. They score! Darcy Kemper was swimming. I don't know what happened to the Colorado netminder.
It's almost like he lost his skate blade because he couldn't get up. He went to stand up, and watch him. He just slips.
Brian, this happened against Ottawa on Monday as well. He had a skate blade come off against the Senators. This is something you rarely see, and for it to happen in consecutive games is remarkable.
Here's what happened with Darcy Kemper when he came out on the ice at the start of the period. Took a couple of strides.
You gotta be kidding me.
It's like a wow.
Darcy Kemper came out, went back to the locker room, and now it's Johansson again going into the Colorado goal.
This is just weird. I mean,
this is bizarre.
There's Camp on it. Protected by Trouba.
Hey, good catch. Oh,
he almost had it.
He almost had it.
Oh, I had it. It was right there. Once upon a time, I would have fielded that.
And you played the Little League World Series, too, like, which you pointed out to me more than once. You were right in the middle of things down there.
Yeah, Muzzin almost clunked me on the coconut. I'm like, really? It's been a rough 10 seconds here.
The referee talking to Frederick Anderson about something right now.
Oh, you know what? It's about the white tape. This is about Dallas Eakins buying some time for his power play. Goaltenders aren't allowed to have colored tape at the very top of their goal stick, the knob of the stick. But really, it's just a delaying tactic so that the Getzlaf line can get a little bit of a rest before this power play starts.
Kreider is there. Thompson for Buffalo with Hague. And the set up.
So close, no matter how far. Couldn't be much more from the heart. Forever, trust. That's how you get the forever. You gotta give it the. Nothing else matters.
That is, I didn't know you could sing like that. You
just want to apologize to everybody at home who had to watch that. Yeah. Hey, but great guitar playing.
It's going to be remarkable when these fans get going. Martin on the puck, gave it away. Here's a chance for Richardson. Scores on a giveaway. Richardson puts it home and gets his second of the season to make a 1-0 Calgary. And then Martin here with, I don't know what he was trying to, a backhand pass, which is not his skill level on the turnaround. Martin trying to get way too fancy in his own zone.
You know, I think another thing that stands out about Seth Jones, Colby, look out, turned over, Yamamoto shoots and scores. Goal exactly. Horn here, fart noise in Chicago, 3-0 after the shorthanded tally.
Obviously not the play they're looking for.
The back-to-back wins, Montreal-Toronto, Matthews in front, shot,
loose in front, how did that, it is in! Michael Bunting and the Leafs have hit six for the first time this year.
Bunting got a little piece of it there off the post and then off the skate of Philippe Deneau and in the back of the net.
Rick Anderson threw a crunching hit, this ricochets in! Protas going to celebrate his first.
Protas throws it to the front of the net, off the defenseman's skate of D'Angelo and right past the left toe of the goaltender.
Noah Hanifin down, off a stick in front of Fleury and in the back of the net. Matthew Tkachuk was trying to center. Seth Jones' stick was on the ice, an unfortunate bounce for the Hawks.
Works it around the boards, Drysdale steps up, keeps it in, and he scores! He just threw it to the net, and the Ducks have tied the game.
Well, they got a bounce. They got a big bounce here, and what a break.
That hit a couple of things. It hit, I think, both Josi and Fabro.
Oh, it does.
Wow,
yeah.
That's a pinball.
It's a double deflection off both Predators defenders. What a break.
And it's kept in there by Coyle. Coyle rolling it across, long screenshot, deflected off into the corner. Comes back to the point again, another blast, that's knocked down, the rebound, and score!
Well, Sabres have a huge problem right there. Miller, Hinostroza, both have no sticks. Right here, look at the exchange in front. Hinostroza throws it to Miller, neither one of them have a stick. The puck comes to the side, they have the two men without sticks. And that's Riley's second goal of the year.
To their lead, Orlov, Arister, stopped by Allen. Rebound taken care of, or is it? No, it's in the net. It is 3-0 on the type of goal rarely seen.
Right off Paquette and then off Romanov.
And it doesn't get much tougher than that for Montreal.
Seattle. There's a shot from the side. And he runs behind it and jammed in as the puck was loose on the goal line.
And I think Darcy Kuemper ends up pushing this one in. It's Darcy Kuemper has no idea where this goes. Looks around, it's off his stick, ends up putting it in.
Only a few points on top.
The angle, try, they score!
It's gonna be Steven Stamkos' goal, and it's a bad one. Difficult angle, and somehow it manages to squeak underneath pad of Carter Hart.
Here's a 2-on-1 for Minnesota. Zuccarello with Rask, a trailer is Kaprizov. They can't get it to him. Then a shot deflects and rolls over Hudobin and falls into the net. It has been that kind of night.
A muffin goes off the top of the head or shoulder of Pavelski, off the mask of Hudobin. Heiskanen looked like a guy with a fork trying to eat soup in behind him.
Is it in deep? Markstrom, stick handling, popped up, they score! Give it away, put home by Reese Johnson, his first NHL goal.
Markstrom actually makes a nice play, good patience, puts it to Lindholm, he can't handle it, and then Markstrom is not ready whatsoever, he's still coming back to the net.
Milano at the line, gains the zone, tried to flip it ahead, that hit Mete went straight up in the air. Milano gets to it first, walks to the slot, hands it off, they score! Raquel converts a goal mouth feed from Zegras.
Here's the puck, it's going to go way up in the air. Milano sees it, knocks it down with the hand, and then the stick. Look at those hands.
Six-piece McNuggets with a minimum $1 purchase. Off this turnover here, great chance, backhand, score! Huberdeau, no mistake for the 1-0 advantage.
Here's the turnover right here by TVR. He mishandles, everybody's moving up ice, and there's the 2-on-0.
Flee to the net, open in front is Radish. Binnington is spread out, net still open. Hedman's shot is deflected, flicked up in the air, still off, now in! What happened there?
Cirelli gets it. Yeah, the cool part, the puck floated up in the air. Radish then whacked it out of midair right off that right post. It snuck over to the other post, and then we saw Cirelli shovel it in. One-timer off the post. Goal! Corey Perry! Tampa Bay has an early 2-0 lead. Tonight in game 1,115. Is Jordan Binnington going to stay between the pipes? Craig Berube having a discussion. Do I pull him?
And it's a weird bounce that comes off of the side, and it just, I mean, couldn't do that if you tried. So that's certainly, look at Binnington looking behind the net, expecting it to rim around, and it just hits a funny stanchion in the glass.
And now to perform the United States National Anthem this afternoon, Rock and Roll Hall of Fame guitarist of The Doors, Robbie Krieger.
Period on the man advantage. There's a giveaway in front. They wave it off. Fans celebrate. Referee right there says no. Nelson back to Aho.
Now they blow.
They sound the horn, so the puck was in.
I think so. Yes.
Yeah, hit the camera.
There we go. Yep, hit the camera. Definitely in the net.
Off the post, off the camera, and then out.
Now Clayton Keller. Little drop out high. And a shot. They score. No. They say no goal. Coyotes are celebrating, but it goes the other way. Kopitar is in. Kopitar, he stopped.
Vemelka, are you kidding me? What is going on here? Capobianco was in full celebration mode.
And that's going to do it. And now they're going to,
This went in.
The horn sounded. They reviewed it. And that means it's a goal, and I think it's Capobianco with the game winner. Unbelievable final minutes here.
Oh, yeah, definitely, without a doubt.
He's protecting the puck. Over to Dvorak, shoots, stopped, and now it's in the net thanks to Josh Anderson getting the insurance marker. The Kings won by a score of 4-2. Here's Josh Anderson diving. Couldn't put it home, but the referee is going to blow the whistle.
And the official calls that a goal with the empty net out.
Still trying to get something else going. Tyler Toffoli in game number 600 puts another one into the gaping net. And Montreal with this 6-3 score.
Sneaks it through two defenders and then pokes it in. Anderson will shoot at the empty net himself. And a diving effort by Fowler will keep it out.
That might have gone in.
I think it had a chance.
Boyle getting back to make it a 2-on-2, and it's a bleeder. Ooh. Off the line by Coyle. I thought I saw daylight between the puck and the back of the goal line.
Yep.
Oh, yeah.
That's a goal.
It was determined that the puck completely crossed the goal line at 15:49.
Manson to the net front. A kick save by Saros. Rebound, what a save!
Oh my gosh, Saros' back was facing the slot area and he used his edge to get his torso turned around to front that shot. What a save.
Up to the far board. Right free by Kreider. Tried that lacrosse move.
That was close.
And I think he thinks it's a goal, and I think the officials agree. Did this go in? I don't know if anybody else in the arena thought it did.
And I think it,
did
it hits the crossbar. Oh, man, I don't think you, AJ, you can't get this any closer.
So no goal, and the Rangers still have not had the lead today.
That pass broken up, it's in the slot, shot, score! Mikko Rantanen has the hat trick, and the hats come raining down at Ball Arena. His third career hat trick.
And I've been looking for more offense from Grizzlick. Here's a drive, rebound, score! Beautiful save by Swayman.
And AJ, he puts that camera to bed.
I mean, look at that. That's a great look at it. I think we got a look from the actual camera. That is a target. Think you could do that again?
Not if you're trying to. That well, camera's no good.
He had to spend a little time fixing it. It's a little worse for the wear.
Garland is waiting. He's got that short grip on the stick, just waiting for something to happen to come over.
but the puck never gets it.
The NHL. Here's Svechnikov coming free and a save. Be kidding!
This is absolute multi-larceny! Grand larceny! Grand larceny! No! Denied! Svechnikov!
Braden Holtby, take a bow in game 500.
Tonight's second star from the Avalanche with an assist on each of the first three goals tonight. Number 8, Cale Makar!